Hey guys, this time on Tim Talks Audio, Studio One's Transform to Audio and Bouncing MIDI. Today, we're going to look at some ways to free up some CPU power by addressing instrument channels. If you have a larger session with lots of virtual instruments, you may notice your CPU working a bit harder than you'd like, and you may even experience issues with playback. Step one would be to check out your device block size, and if you don't know how to do that, just take a look at this video and it'll explain everything. If you have already addressed your device block size and are still seeing your CPU working hard, then we can take a look at rendering some of your instrument tracks. The first way is to bounce your instrument part. Bouncing will write a new audio event and auto-populate an audio channel with that new bounced file. It will also auto-mute the MIDI event, so you don't get a double trigger of the instrument part as well as the new audio track. You can do this by right-clicking in the event region and choosing Bounce Selection, or use the keyboard shortcut of Command or Control B. There is one downside to this, though. Even though your new audio track is exactly what the instrument would have played and how it would have sound, this still leaves the instrument track active, as you can see here. You certainly could then go ahead and remove that instrument yourself and free up the processing power, or just turn the instrument off or into bypass. I'm going to quickly undo my bounce and show you Transform to Audio. Transform to Audio track is another way to free up some CPU power. This is a non-destructive rendering of your instrument part to an audio file. Again, there's a couple ways to do this. You could right-click on the track in the main edit window and select Transform to Audio track, or make yourself a keyboard shortcut. In my case, Control T. When you do this, you'll get this dialog box. In here, you can choose to also render any inserts that you have on your instruments. You can preserve the instrument track, which is great if you want to modify a part again after you've rendered it. And you can remove the instrument. Removing the instruments and rendering the inserts is the combination you'll want to free up some of that CPU power. This last option is for tails. You would adjust these settings if you had a reverb on your track as well and wanted to ensure that the tail of the reverb got rendered into the track as well. You can select Auto Tail and it will auto-populate a max length of 30 seconds, or you can adjust your own fixed tail by clicking and dragging, or just double-clicking and inserting an amount of time. I'm going to put this back down to zero and show you what happens when we transform this to an audio part. There. Now we have a brand new audio part which still shows the information of the MIDI, but it's gone ahead and removed the instrument and put my insert in the rendered audio file and removed the insert from the track. I can go back and adjust the part or the settings in my insert by transforming it back to an instrument part. And it's a very similar process. You can right-click on the track and transform to instrument track, or, using a keyboard shortcut, Control-Shift-T. Now it's exactly the way it was before I did my render. There's some extra good news. This also works on audio channels. I have here a hidden guitar DI part with an instance of Ampere. I can do a similar action and transform this to a rendered audio file, and then back again with my shortcuts. You can right-click and select Transform to Rendered Audio, or Option B for me, and it gives me this dialog box with very similar settings. If I've done my render and need to adjust something, I can easily go back by transforming back to real-time audio, or in my case, Control B. Because this is an audio track and not an instrument track, it is technically a different function, therefore having different shortcuts, but it will do the same thing in the end and it will free up some CPU power. That's all for now. If you found anything in this video informative, please like and share the video. Or if you have a question about how to do something in Studio One, please leave a comment. Thanks for watching.